In this video, we are going to learn how the efficiency of the emitter is defined and which models are applied to calculate its losses. In particular, in this video, we will see a definition of emitter efficiency and two of the most used empirical models to effectively compute the emitter performance. As we will be able to see, these models are the weighted efficiency models and the Sandia National Laboratories model, the so-called SNL model. The efficiency of the emitter is defined as the ratio between the power output at the AC side and the power input at the DC side. This definition comprises the complete emitter unit. Since the real emitter has many components and due to the lack of detailed data from emitter manufacturers, some models have been developed to describe the efficiency. These models are based on empirical formulas. It is important to note that the efficiency here reported is an instantaneous value, which means that it is time dependent. In fact, both AC and DC power are computed in time, therefore it is possible to evaluate the performance over time. In order not to waste electricity produced by the PV system, an inverter should always work as close as possible to its maximum achievable efficiency. However, the inverter efficiency is not constant, but strongly depends on the DC input voltage and the total DC input power. Given that an inverter cannot be 100% efficient, a typical shape of the efficiency graph is the one shown in the slide. In this case, the behavior is referred to a transformerless type of inverter. Different efficiencies can be found for different types and models of inverters, such as ones with the mains transformer and the high-frequency transformer. It should be noted that every inverter and every manufacturer show a different behavior when it comes to efficiencies. This variety of patterns suggests that it is almost impossible to provide with an analytical and unified model for the inverter efficiency. This explains why the inverter efficiency as a function of the input DC power for various DC voltage levels is usually given in the datasheet. A quite reliable way of expressing the inverter efficiency with a single number is to use weighted efficiencies. This method combines the inverter efficiencies of a wide range of solar expositions. Two different weighted efficiencies are commonly used. First, the European efficiency, which represents a low insolation climate, such as in Central Europe. And second, the California Energy Commission CEC efficiency, which represents the PV system performance in high insolation regions, such as in the southwest of the United States. Eta values, like the one in the red circle, denote the efficiency at a certain percentage of nominal power of the inverter. Even if weighted efficiencies are a more accurate approximation of the effective performance of the inverter compared to the peak efficiency, it is still only an average value. It is if a better estimate of the real-time power output of a PV system is needed, a more accurate representation of the instantaneous inverter performance at every level of input power and voltage must be developed. Due to the lack of detailed data from inverter manufacturers, many research institutes around the world have published extended data, which are publicly available online. This data present efficiency curves for a large range of inverters as a function of several characteristic parameters. One useful database is the one provided by Sandia National Laboratories. The SNL model takes into account different types of losses, which include the losses linked to the self-consumption of the inverter, the losses related to all semiconductor devices composing the inverter, the switching losses that arise in the pulse width modulation bridge part of the inverter, and the ohmic losses given by the current flowing in the internal circuitry of the converter device. To show an inverter efficiency curve, some experimental data need to be retrieved. In the following case, field test measurements were taken during a period of 13 days with changing weather conditions. The relationship between the AC and the DC power appears to be almost linear, even though we will see that this is not entirely the case. The power consumption of the inverter itself, together with the electrical characteristics of the switching modes and circuits at different power levels, results in a degree of nonlinearity between AC and DC power at a given DC voltage level. The inverter efficiency from experimental data, as we have seen before, is not constant, but varies with the input power. The fact that the efficiency is not constant explains why there is a nonlinearity between a DC input and AC output. With the SNL model, it is possible to define some parameters that help describing the efficiency of the inverters. Let's consider a device working at a nominal voltage VDC0. It is possible to notice that the pattern changes whether we work with a lower or a higher voltage. It is important to underline that in the graph shown, the nonlinearity of the input-output behavior of the inverter is emphasized. The AC power limit for which the inverter is designed is PAC0 and provides the nominal DC power PDC0 when it crosses the nominal voltage line. The curvature C0 is the parameter used to describe the nonlinear nature of the inverter characteristic. Additionally, other parameters are usually provided such as PS0, which is the self-consumption of the inverter, and the PNT, or night terror, of the inverter. The dependency of the inverter efficiency on the DC input voltage is a very complex phenomenon. For a given inverter, there is a different behavior when the DC voltage is lower, equal, or higher than the nominal voltage of the inverter. Nevertheless, for a different type of inverter, a higher voltage can lead to higher efficiencies or vice versa. The differences between the different inverter types can partially be explained by the different types of switches used. The SNL model provides also some empirical formulas for the AC power output as function of different parameters, most of them already described in the previous slides. Let's take a look at these formulas. PAC0 is the nominal AC power of the inverter. PDC is the instantaneous DC power provided by the PV array. Then some other parameters are used. A is an empirical value, as well as B and C, all shown in the screen. In these three parameters, we can find some coefficients already seen before, such as PDC0, which is the nominal DC power input, PS0, which is the night or self-consumption of the inverter, VDC, which is the PV array side voltage, and the VDC0, which is the nominal DC voltage value. The last parameters are always provided by the manufacturers of the inverter. These are C0, which, as we saw before, takes into account the curvature of the characteristic, C1, C2, and the C3, that are purely empirical parameters. The efficiency of the MPPT is not included in the SNL performance model. This is because the efficiency of most maximum power point triggers used in the inverters ranges between 98 and nearly 100% at every level of input DC power, and the voltage provided is always within the accepted minimum and maximum window for the MPPT to work correctly. A decrease of 1% in the system performance has therefore been used to take the MPPT losses into account. Among the other losses worth to be mentioned, we can mention the mismatch between modules, which accounts for 1.5%, ohmic losses related to external cabling of the inverter, usually considered to be around 0.5% if not determined analytically, and finally, soling losses as an additional loss of 1%. To recap, we have seen the simple formula of the inverter efficiency and found that the behavior of the inverter is not constant for every input power level. Since an analytical description would be very complicated and the manufacturers often do not provide all the data necessary to develop a physical model, empirical formulas and models have been developed. Among them, it is worth mentioning the Euro and the CEC weighted efficiencies that consider the behavior for different solar expositions. Then we saw that the Sandia National Laboratory model provides parameters and data in order to model the inverter efficiency, taking into account both the DC power and the DC voltage. Using the parameters given by this model and by the inverter manufacturers, the AC power output can be computed as a function of the DC input. In this way, it is possible to choose the proper inverter for the PV system and to take into account the losses generated during the power conversion.